Okay, let's just pray for Sister Janine's friend. Understand that one of his closest friends just got blown up in service.
Yes.
I'm on service. Okay, let's just all pray. Father, we thank you, Father, for strength and help. You, the Lord, that's touched with the feelings of our infirmity. You relate to everything that we go through. Lord, you said for us to come boldly before the throne of grace to ask for mercy and grace to help us in the time of need. Father, this is the time that we need your grace. We need your help. We need your strength. Lord, we need you to uphold us. We need your comfort. We need you, Lord. Lord, we thank you that you said for us to trust in you, cast all of our cares, to fear not, neither be dismayed. You would be our God. You would be our helper. You will be our strengthener. You would uphold us. Father, we thank you today for upholding us, giving us strength to go through. Hallelujah. Father, you said that you touched and you have already experienced everything that we could ever experience. And Father, since you have been through the disappointments, the heartaches, and the frustrations, and all of the grief, and the sorrow and pain, you know how to deliver them. You know how to rescue those that are going through and experiencing these types of adversities. Father, we give you praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, the name above every name, we thank you, God, for the victory. For this is the victory that overcomes even our faith. We give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're going to have a special prayer before the service is over for that young man. I just want to take notes today if you possibly can, because I feel that this is a message designed for people that have chronic needs, people that have gone for years, gone through limitations and frustrations and barriers and heartaches and sickness or disease. And we just believe that it's time for us to, amen, understand clearly how we can be free and rid of whatever the enemy has brought into our path. Amen. I just believe that God's word is above the devil's words. How many can say amen? Scripture says where sin abound, God's grace does what? Much more. Amen. So God's grace is supposed to do a jillion times more than what Satan's power, amen, has done against us. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Today, I'm going to give you the text. This is Psalms 145. We've already prayed. And Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9. I just want you to turn to that particular passage because this teaching today perhaps is the most important of all teachings that one could give that will build your faith to the point where you actually can receive whatever you're seeking from the hands of the Lord. Amen. This scripture says, Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9, the Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All right, verse 14, I'll just read that. The Lord upholdeth all that fall, raises up all those that be bowed down. So each one of these scriptures will show you that God is for you. One thing that this passage will teach, and this message will teach, that God is really for you. Amen. Sometimes we look upon God as being a tight-fisted person, a tight-fisted God, that's looking for some reason to keep you from receiving. But Jesus said that I am come that you might have life. He didn't say that I came that you might not have. He said, I came that you might have what? Life, and have life more abundantly. So the scripture says he upholdeth all, not some, all that fall. How many have ever fallen? How many have ever been victimized by some ploy or scheme? Amen. That Satan sent and launched in your direction. But the scripture says, and raises up all those that be bowed down. That means when you're bowed down spiritually, I mean, you're still experiencing a whole lot of pain and discomfort. The eyes of all, verse 15, wait upon thee, thou givest them their meat in due season. Thou openest thine hand and satisfieth the desire of every living thing. The Lord is nigh unto all that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. That's one of my favorite scriptures. He said, the Lord is nigh unto all that call upon him. In other words, he's very close. Amen. You don't have to, the Bible says his hand ain't short, it can't save, his ear heavy, that he can't hear. God is nigh unto all of those that are what? Amen. Praise God. All of those that call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. Amen. That's a qualifier there. He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. Now write this down. Fear means a wholesome dread of displeasing God. A wholesome dread of displeasing God. If you're the type of person who's totally committed to pleasing God, in other words, that's one of the foundations that we might understand, that we need to understand that our faith needs to be built upon obedience. Everybody say obedience. Amen. All of the blessings that God has ever promised us is based on obedience, I mean, to the saints. Every blessing is contingent upon our obedience.
Right.
Amen. I'm not thinking of any amens then.
Amen.
To the sinner, he commands them to what? Repent and believe.
Amen.
Right? And for us, he tells us that we got to what? We got to obey. Amen. If you obey and serve him, he says you'll spend your days in what? Prosperity. And your years in pleasure. Oh, I want to spend my days in what? Pleasure.
Amen.
Oh, Mahashanda.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I just want to be able where I can just rejoice in the Lord always.
Amen.
And again.
Amen.
And again, I say, rejoice.
Yes.
Amen. I think God wants us to be the happiest people in the world.
Yes.
Rejoicing in all these long faces and all these ugly looks and sad countenances. It just got to go. These little mealy-mousy praising, you know, I don't want to, amen, mess up my face. I don't want to look ugly and funny. Amen. Praise God. But the scripture says, from the rising of the sun,
hallelujah,
hey, to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord is going to be what? All right, so all of this is speaking about praising God. I mean, pleasing God. A wholesome dread of displeasing God. God wants to be worshipped. Amen. The scripture says we're the circumcision. We worship God in the spirit. Ooh, I love that. We worship God in the spirit. Circumcision means people that are really saved. Everybody that, amen, praise God, that got the name on the membership roll. Amen. You know, amen. Everybody, praise God. You know, somebody said that if a mule, if you can write the mule's name on the barn door, if you can, amen, write the mule's name on the barn door, amen, and shake the mule's hand, that'll make you a mule. Would that make you a mule? No. Amen. So you just can't put your name, have your name on the what? The church roll and just say, well, I'm a believer, amen, and be one in reality. You got to what? Walk the walk. You got to do more than what? Talk the talk.
Amen.
A whole lot of people walk it by the what? Inch. And they what? They talk it by the mile. Amen. Everybody talking about heaven ain't going there. Boy, it's going to be amazing to see, amen, who's going to make it. Amen. I'm getting quiet now. Not everyone that says, Lord, Lord, is going to what? Enter in. But it's going to be the one that will what? Do the will of the Father. The reason why I'm kind of focusing on fearing God, which means that you are wholesome dread of this. Whatever you know that doesn't please God, the Bible says, a wholesome dread of anything that displeases God. You just won't do, continue to do anything that you know. Amen. He that knoweth to do good and don't do it, to him is what? Sin. Amen. How much shall we rejoice? Amen. Sin is sin, and sin will what? Kill. It will what? Destroy. Amen. And sin will what? Take you to hell. But Jesus said that I am come that you might have what? Life. God is full of compassion. He's, everybody said full. He doesn't want anybody what? To miss out on any provision that he has what? Made. But he's not just going to dump all of these blessings on you without you what? Making some type of what? Commitment. You have to what? Do whatever he tells you to do. Amen. Is that right? Suppose God operate without rules. How many would love a God like that? Anything. I just bless you anyway. Amen. All of these blessings are ours, but they're all contingent upon what? Amen. God can't overrule his law and what? Disregard whatever commandment he's what? Laid down. Amen. To what? To be compassionate toward you. Amen. There's a what? Price you have to pay. And the Bible says, amen, his blessings is upon them that fear him. Right. Amen. It's that qualifying word of ignorance right all through the Bible. Those that what? Fear him. The Bible says the willing and the obedient shall eat the good of the land. Amen. Everybody said the willing and the obedient. Amen. So follow peace with all men and holiness without which no man shall what? See the Lord. Amen. Now God is still compassionate, full of mercy. Amen. Plenteous. Amen. And I believe that we ought to do everything that we can to please him. Is that right? Hey, the Bible says he's the rewarder of him that will what? Diligently. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous one will prevail when we walk in that particular fear. So God has a lot of blessings out there, but these blessings, you know, for the sinner, sometimes people say, well, it seems like God is more compassionate to sinners and people that don't know than he is to saints. Have you ever seen people? Because sometimes sinners can come up and they'll what, just get their breakthrough, get delivered, get healed. And sometimes saints just, amen, they, you know, they just go through change after change after change, years and years and years and years, and never get straightened out. Sometimes you say, well, see, that God loves the sinner more than he loves the saint. But actually, he loves the saint more than he loves the what? Sinner. He loves both. He's so full of compassion that he just can't limit his blessings on what? On saints. He ain't going to limit, amen, his blood because he got too much of it. So he's just going to pour it out to what? To sinners. But even sinners have to what? Meet some type of criteria. What do they have to do? Repent and believe. That's right. Amen. Y'all don't love me, do you? All right. He's full of compassion. Now, the scripture that I want to emphasize, today, as big as I can, that God is what? He's full. Everybody say he's full. He's full of compassion. Amen. Scripture says that as far as the, amen, as high as the heavens are above us. Amen. Just look up and see if you can see the heaven. And you can't see a thing. Amen. But if you went out. All right. If you went straight up, how long would it take you to, amen, if you had some way of getting to the heavens? They said, amen, it would take, what, trillions and trillions of years to try to get to the heavens. Amen. That's how much compassion God got. As far as the what? That's right. As far as the east is from, how far is that? Don't nobody know. As far as the east is from the west, so far, amen, God has removed our iniquities from us. So God got mercy. God got so much mercy. So much. Everybody says so much. So much compassion. So many blessings. Hallelujah. Praise God. And even, amen, God's grace, the Bible refers to God's grace as Jesus was what? Full of grace. Ooh, I love that. Full full of grace and what? True.
Yes.
Full of. Everybody said full of grace.
Full of grace.
Now let me just tell you, amen. Mercy is a blessing. You know, there are all kinds of mercies. That's the mercy of healing. Mercy of provision, right? Mercy of what? Protection. Mercy of healing. What else? Mercy of what? Righteousness. He's our righteousness, right? All of these are blessings. The Bible says His mercies are new every morning.
Every morning
you look around, there's another one, mercy. You know, mercy is God not giving you what you deserve. That's what mercy is. But grace is giving you what you didn't deserve. So grace, since Jesus has come to bring grace and truth, the fountain of mercies and blessings have been what? Open up. Wow. Oh, Jesus. Because, see, grace, amen, means what? The sum total of everything that God has done for us and provided us through Christ Jesus. Woo! Everything. It's all of God's mercy, all of His love, all of His goodness, all of His kindness, all of His provisions, all of His blessings, woo! It's the sum total of all that God has provided for us through Jesus Christ. Somebody say, it's God's riches. And Christ says, what? Exists. Amen. In the age of grace and truth, that means all of those mercies that came on Israel have been what? Have been what? Expanded. God has just what? Pull out all stops. Ain't no limit. Scripture says, eye hasn't seen, neither ear has heard, neither has it entered into the heart of men the things that God has prepared for them that what? Love Him. Amen. So grace is the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ and everything that He is presently doing for us through the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. That's the reason why God sent the Holy Ghost. Because, amen, it meant that what? He could do a lot more when He came into us. Woo, to what? To live in us. See, God can lead you inwardly now. You don't have to have no what? You don't have to have a Moses or Joshua. Well, you need pastors, amen, but even with a pastor, amen, you're supposed to be what? Led by your spirit. Is that right? Amen. The Holy Ghost has been placed on the inside of us. Everybody said the Holy Ghost is in us. And one of the functions of the Holy Ghost is to what? To give us strength and to lead, to guide, to come. Everything that a natural shepherd would do for their sheep, amen, in the natural, that's exactly what the Holy Ghost is designed to do, amen, for us through the Spirit. He's my comfort. He's my guide. He's my what? He's my healer. Yeah, amen. When Christ comes in, amen, that means what? More life. We are delivered. Amen. The scripture says we are saved by His what? Life. It's, amen. The Spirit of the law of life in Christ Jesus makes us what? Free. It's the Holy Ghost on the inside of us. Makes us what? Free from the law of sin. Everybody know, point to your belly. Down in there, point to your belly. The Holy Ghost is down in there. And the Bible says He effectually worketh in them that believe. Amen. He's acting as a guide, acting as a comforter, acting as a keeper, as a strengthener, as a leader, as a blesser, as a one that goes alongside of you. Amen. Praise God. As a deliverer. Hey, hallelujah. And a healer. He's in there making life. The devil is out here. Amen. He's running to and fro trying to what? Keep you from having life. But God's eyes are what? Running to and fro. Amen. The devil is walking, but God's eyes are running. Hallelujah. And He's looking all, ooh, glory. Hey, boy, I ain't never been as happy as I am now in my whole life, Sister Julie. Hallelujah. And I'm a fool for Christ's sake, if you want to know. I'm a fool. Y'all can just
Amen.
But I want hallelujah to understand, amen. I want to what to live as close as I can. Amen. Because what? God's blessings upon them that fear him. That fear him. He's nigh unto them that what? Call upon him. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. The Bible says, amen.